and this is my dedication to you.
The royal coronation at Savannah State University has a history as rich as the university itself. Each Mr. and Miss Savannah State symbolizes values of integrity, scholarship, and leadership. They are chosen not only for their beauty or popularity, but for their commitment to fostering a positive environment and inspiring others. The tradition continues on as we meet the 2024-2025 Mr. and Miss Savannah State University, Nadia Quells and Michael O. Taylor.
I am a first semester senior, but typically a senior, and I major in business management with a minor in marketing. And I serve as the 87th Miss Savannah State University.
I am a senior criminal justice major. I humbly serve as the 9th gracious Mr. Savannah State University for the 24-25 academic school year.
As we meet our new candidates, they can't help but tell us exactly how excited they felt when hearing their names as the winners.
It was an amazing feeling. Honestly, I ran unopposed a few days prior to voting, so I kind of knew I already won, but I wanted to feel the student body's impact on how I impacted their lives, how many people I shaped, how many people I helped, how many people I reached during campaign season. People coming to hear my table, see my speech, what am I about, my platform. So honestly, when Stowe said it, I already knew, but the fact that those many people voted for me, it was an amazing feeling.
Although I was the only candidate running for Mr. Savannah State, it was still kind of like a surreal moment for me. Just like having the title as big as Mr. Savannah State, being that, you know, the head honcho of your university. You know, when you think of Savannah State University, you think of the president, the vice president, the chief justice, as well as the Mr. and Miss. So it's great being the face of the school and just representing my school well at everything that I do. When I walk off campus, even the people down the street at the restaurant, like, hey, I've seen you on the news. Who are you? I'm Mr. Savannah State.
One of the most important days of their reign is the royal coronation. This is when the king and queen are officially crowned. With this day comes days of preparation.
The moment that we get crowned, because it's like now it's official. You know what I'm saying?
This week, definitely coronation. I'm really excited to get my crown dressed up. Like, I might even shed a tear. Like, I'm really excited.
I have been an employee at the institution since 2002. I became the advisor to Miss Savannah State in 2002. And so I have done that role and coordinating coronation since then. And that's what, 22 years? A long time. So advising coronation, advising Miss Savannah State and helping to put together coronation is absolutely wonderful. It's very stressful, but it is a beautiful thing for a young person that has dreamt all of their life to be Mr. or Miss, and now they get that night where they officially get their crown. So it's a beautiful thing. I love doing it.
A coronation should start planning a year in advance. You should start planning it as soon as the last one's over. I mean, that will keep the stress down. That'll keep people from forgetting things or overlooking things. Better make sure that all T's are crossed and all I's are dotted. And there's some other aspects to a coronation, like the funding portion.
Months of preparation go into this one magical night. Students and faculty come together to design a ceremony worthy of the title and crown. Decorations are carefully chosen, speeches rehearsed, and outfits meticulously planned to capture the elegance and pride of Savannah State.
Yes, they have very good imaginations. And so the goal for me and Mr. Stowe is to ask the king and queen, what is it from that night that you just cannot live without, that you've envisioned? And so knowing that coins are low sometimes, we try to do that particular thing. And it comes with a theme of what they see themselves. Either in a castle, we've had under the sea, you know, we've had folks coming, rising up, yeah. So whatever it is that they see for themselves that night, we try to make sure that the theme fits that and give them that one thing that they want.
It has been, I would say, difficult. Just booking hair appointments. I just had my birthday last Saturday, so I was like, maybe I can prepare early, book my hair appointment, got my nails done, toes done, all of that, doing my fitting for my dress, just came back from Atlanta, making sure everything is okay with that.
So just, you know, just the planning and stuff for homecoming, coronation. Like I said, just wanted everything to be right and everything perfect. The planning, I'm not gonna lie, my head was just all over the place. And I know I told you before that I try not to get in my head a little bit. I just try to let things, like, you know, just go with the flow. But it kind of was getting a little stressful. Like I said, just referring back to the hurricanes and stuff that we were having, suits and stuff not coming on time, having to order alternate suits for coronation and homecoming game. It has been, you know, a lot. But I'm just like, okay, I'm not going to let this stress me out.
Day in and day out, both Nadia and Michael have been gearing up for their coronation night on October 24th. However, having a lot on one's plate can cause a lot more than they think.
Well, stress can be good and bad. I'm quite sure you're talking about being overstressed, right? But we are taught that anxiety is more future-oriented, while fear is more present-oriented. So, you know, stress can be a motivator. A certain amount of stress is needed, but when you feel overstressed, when you take on too much on your plate, when you are, you know, overwhelmed,
definitely stressful. This Greek step show, like I told them, y'all, I had to play a small part. I want to be on the team, but hey, I'm Miss Savannah State. I'm busy. Like, just give me a small part. I want to, you know, feel incorporated. Like, this is still my NEO year. I just crossed Spring 24, so I do want to feel included in everything.
I would definitely say, you know, balancing the academics and being Mr. Savannah State. I actually, at one point, I literally forgot I was a student. I'm just doing, you know, just doing king work and, you know, just getting stuff done, going to these different conferences, meeting with so many different people.
Like, let's say if they're part of like SGA and they're running for like the Mr. Of the university, they need to have what like the CSA call like a sponsor or like a partner. So having a partner is very crucial, not just for financial support, but someone that's checking up on you and making sure you, like I said, you have everything that you need. So to be a successful queen, not just have a successful show, I would recommend getting a partner, whether it's a business partner or on campus, or even if it's like the nail tech in your, you know, salon in your neighborhood, but just showing that you're not doing this by yourself.
Now, just a few days before coronation night, Nadia and Michael are just filled with excitement for what's to come.
Coronation practice has actually been good. I love seeing the campus kings and queens' faces. They're really excited. They've been getting their dress approved, their tux approved. They're learning their dance. Me and Michael, we practiced on last week learning our dance. So I'm really excited. I'm ready to see the big picture, see how everything's gonna be laid out, the glitz, the glamour. For me, Michael, the elegant, like, I'm ready to see lights, camera, action.
We've just been trying to ensure that we have everything that we need, everything that we want our coronation to be. This is, you know, just a once in a lifetime type of thing. So it's kind of been hectic, but we've been getting things done. We've been getting things in order. We're 2 days away from coronation at this point. So it's like all gas, no break.
On Thursday, October 24th of 2024, held in the Tiger Arena at Savannah State University, Nadia Quails and Michael O. Taylor Jr. were officially crowned and have now joined the royal legacy.
Okay, homecoming week was amazing. It was definitely tiring. Like,
yes.
We are exhausted.
Yes.
But it was all worth it. Definitely coronation would have to be my favorite day. Like, we really did that for coronation, so yeah. That would have to be my favorite day.
Yeah, I would definitely agree. Coronation, like, that day was just, like, literally about the Mr. and Miss, and we represent our university really well. We put a lot of hard work and dedication into our university. So it just feels good to, like, you know, be rewarded and, you know, just get crowned and, you know, get what I get and stuff like that. So, you know, it was really a good moment. The final product, I was kind of like, okay, it is tied in with a lot of the theme that we wanted, the glitz, the glam, as well as what I wanted too was more kind of like the elegance and, you know, stuff like that. And it kind of, like I said, it had both of our ideas together and it came together pretty well, I think.
Yes, it did. I just have to say, it came together. We was
really nervous about our car because we wanted to make a grand entrance. We were supposed to have a Corvette, but unfortunately, you know, the man backed out. So we was like, who do we know that has a good car? We can make something stand out, never done before.
Never done before.
Yes, at Savannah State. We was like, let's get a Cybertruck.
Yeah.
And our boy, Ollie, pulled through. So it was just an amazing time.
He did.
Before one looks into the ceremony, one must first take a look back. The coronation is more than a ceremony. It is a celebration of heritage, unity, and the bright future of Savannah State University. Each Mr. and Miss becomes part of an unbreakable legacy, which can either go forward or backwards.
I definitely like coronation on the Thursday before the game. Ultimately, it just celebrates us keeping the retention, keeping the celebration going on, the tradition within the campus. So I'm glad they did change it to where we get our own day, we're celebrated, and then the football players get their own day. They're celebrated on Saturday. The alumni comes back. We're all rooting for them to win. So ultimately, like the separate days.
Yeah. So I definitely feel like we are in a different time and age now. You know, we did try to keep some of the tradition at coronation, which was, you know, like the orange, the blue, and stuff like that. We just, like I said, we just wanted to incorporate something new, something different, something that's kind of like me and Nadia's personality. Yeah. We both have big personalities.
Yeah.
We both like over the top. So we just felt like Cybertruck.
Yeah.
Like that's big, that's extravagant, that's over the top.
Well, I would just like to say this has been an amazing feeling. I'm glad the student body trusted me, voted me into this position. My family helped me, encouraged me throughout this whole entire time. And Miss 87, Nadia Qualls, is signing out.
Thank you guys for trusting me as your ninth Mr. Savannah State University to lead this institution. Mr. Savannah State, signing out.
Last night, we not only celebrated two extraordinary students, but the enduring spirit of Savannah State. May the crowns they wear remind us all of the promise of greatness within each Tiger. Here's to another year, another legacy, in another crowning moment in the history of Savannah State University.